this is my space and this is my, I just can relax here and I can just like escape for a little while.
I know God is, He knows what is going on inside of me, like what I think and what I feel.
Twenty-six-year-old Bjarke lives in a flat in Aarhus. He studies to become a teacher. For 4 years, Bjarke has been Christian.
I practice my religion by coming to church on Sunday and then by praying. When I pray, I go into my like room and then I pray the Lord's Prayer, and then I just talk to God and also try to listen to Him.
Although Christianity wasn't a part of his childhood, it now plays a big role in his life.
My relationship to God is the most important relationship I have. I think in many ways it saved me in my life.
Christine also lives in Aarhus. She's 20 years old and studies theater.
This is what I call my sacred space.
She describes herself as spiritual.
I believe in energies. I believe in healing. I believe in the universe. If I gotta connect all these things I'm believing to like one thing, it's spirituality.
Most of Christina's knowledge about spirituality comes from books and social media, but already as a child she had a big interest in crystals.
When I first started collecting crystals, I was very young. It was also rocks I found on the beach.
Spirituality is hard to define, but often spiritual practices are individual and linked to finding peace and guidance in everyday life. Christina's spirituality is manifold. Among other things, she does sound healing and lays tarot, angel, and oracle cards. Her crystals are used for healing purposes and meditation.
I'm channeling the energy through my body, so I would put one of the amethyst points this way, so the energy would go through this and just like shoots in my body, and the other I would put the other direction, so like I would visualize like the light positive would fill up my body while the negative old energy would like shoot out of my body.
Henrik Christensen, associate professor in religion at Aarhus University, sees that young people's attitudes towards religion and belief have changed in recent time.
So for the last 20-25 years, I would say that what we've witnessed is that young people, they increasingly feel that religion is no longer an obligation. So previously you were obliged to take part in religion with your parents and with your kin and your family, but today it is much more a voluntary thing that people choose to do if they like to do it. So that's one development. Another important issue is that religion is more individualized, so people, especially young people, will pick and choose from different traditions. They can be member of the majority church, but at the same time do yoga in a spiritual way, or believe in reincarnation, or use crystals and follow various Instagram influences of different spiritual backgrounds.
When Christine is 16, she gets anxiety. She's diagnosed with schizophrenia. This is when her spirituality starts to blossom.
My life just crashed. I was, it was awful, and I just thought I didn't have like a really purpose in life anymore. And I find this just, there was some kind of peace in this spirituality where you can just relax in meditation, like just, like mindfulness, I found really helpful.
Bjarke's faith also comes to him at a difficult time in his life.
I had a pretty big depression. I was working in a kindergarten, and then I came home and just laying in my bed and watching television.
Bjarke starts taking antidepressants. They trigger a psychosis, which leads to an episode he now recognizes in the Bible.
Lignelsen om det mistede får over om den tabte mønt.
During Bjarke's psychosis, he tries to escape everything and starts biking all the way to South Africa at 4 o'clock in the morning.
I couldn't find meaning in anything, so I was just, oh, I can just go to South Africa, it doesn't matter anyways. Hvis en af jer har 100 får og mister et af dem, lader han så ikke de 99 blive i ødemarken og gå ud efter det, han har mistet, indtil han finder det?
In a forest outside of Aarhus, Bjarke gets off his bike to take a pee. But in the darkness, he can't find his bike again. He finally goes home to his parents, and the day after, he gets hospitalized.
Og når han kommer hjem, kalder han sine venner og naboer sammen og siger til dem, glæd jer med mig, for jeg har fundet det får, jeg havde mistet. I think God like saves me because I was so far out. So for me just to get back to my parents safely, I think that was like a miracle for me. Jeg siger jer, sådan bliver der større glæde i himlen over en synder, der omvender sig, end over 99 retfærdige, som ikke har brug for omvendelse. I feel like I was the missing sheep, and then I was lost, and I think God like come into my life and saved me out from the darkness, and gave like light into my life, and yeah.
Professor Henrik Christensen sees that belief can have a positive impact on a person's well-being.
If we look at people from various religions, they often describe a higher sense of meaning and purpose in life than non-religious people. And we can also see that in different or in various religious denominations, people are more healthy physically, but also mentally. This does not mean, however, that you can just convert into any religion in the hope of getting healthy, both physically and mentally, but that some of the issues that are important for people that are religious has as a side effect also some positive consequences for their life in general. So being part of a religious group gives you a close-knit community at times. It gives you a sense of purpose in life. So it is more of a byproduct of being in a religion more than it is the religious experience of God or of gods or a universal life force that makes you healthy. So the meaning framework is a very large framework that glosses over a lot of nuances. If meaning can be ascribed to a higher religious transcendent entity, that is a way different from ascribing meaning to seeing universal life forces in crystals and plants and these kind of things.
Being spiritual has improved Christina's life in many ways.
I've become much more positive because for me everything vibrates. Negativity vibrates in a different way, and positivity, and I used to be really negative. Take your own time. You don't have to rush through life, and I don't need to hurry. Now I just enjoy the little things in like everyday life. Just stop up and think about what I'm grateful for today. Holding on to those little things, it's very important for me, and I've learned that throughout this whole spiritual journey I've been on.
On Sundays, Bjarke goes to evening service at Vineyard. a private modern church in Aarhus Nord. Many young people come here for the relaxed atmosphere and the social community.
I actually get a feeling of being high when I'm at the service. I don't know if it's the love or the Holy Spirit or what it is that makes me feel that way. But I'm really feeling like good inside when we are singing and the priests are saying some good things and stuff like that.
Jeg har lavet alle mine lektier, jeg har drak mig aldrig fuld, jeg lavede ikke noget kissermiseri med pigerne. Jeg var sådan dydighed.
For 3 years, Bjarke went to a more traditional church. A friend introduced him to Vineyard, and now he's been a part of it for 1 year.
Being at Vineyard gives me a community where I feel at home.
Hej Karoline, jeg vil gerne have en blodappelsin.
I finally found a place where I felt welcome and seen.
It's not like there is a right or wrong in spirituality, and I kind of like that about it because there's not this is the answer. It's very much an individual journey you go on when you start into going into spirituality. I pulled the card. Oh wait, fill out the card, align your life. I chose the card that just fell out because that's actually for me it's a stronger sign from the universe than just for myself to pick a card. It tells me that I need to be true to myself, be honest, not only with myself, but also with other people. I have a hard time saying no to things. So this is a sign from the universe telling me that this is what I need to focus on. If I have these things to believe in, it really calms me down. And I also think because of my schizophrenia, it really helped me through hard times. And I do not have to believe in spirituality, but I can't stop believing. It was not something I chose to believe in. It just came into my life and now I can't get rid of it. And I do not want to get rid of it at all. I want more of it.
Like my faith tells me that no matter what, I'm good enough. So it doesn't matter how good my education is and how much money I earn or how many friends I have. It doesn't matter. I'm loved no matter what.